I got my coffee song, and you know, it's all about how we all love the coffee.
Yeah.
But I have woven into it the fact that when I'm talking about coffee, I'm talking about black coffee. Mm. It's like a little message to myself. It's like, none of you cappuccinos.
Yeah, so it's clear that that song is not for latte drinkers.
No, that song is about my life. Earlier this year, I gave up drinking except for winter. Tried to give up for 9 months, and I failed. But I've only dabbled over that 9 months.
Mm-hmm.
And then in Edinburgh, a day right near the beginning of the Edinburgh Festival, I think it must have been a Monday, I came up with the concept of Martini Monday, which is a good one.
That's brilliant. Yeah, but then that's a rule, isn't it? That you...
Yeah, and I adhered to it very well for 3 to 4 weeks, in both senses.
Was it just martinis you had, though?
No. You know, Edinburgh loves comedy that isn't stand-up. Mm. It's so skewed towards that being amazing.
Yeah.
Oh, this person does jokes without even talking, you know.
Yeah.
Or whatever it is, you know, sketch or deconstruction. Mm. It's like, I'm very happy to do it properly.
I know what you mean.
It took me a while to work up that relationship. But if someone comes to my show and says, I don't really like it because it's stand-up, you know, I'm like, well, bad luck, because that's what it is, you know.
Mm.
And I am a bit of a polymath. Just by my nature, and I've always found that the best thing to do is try and put them together. That's how I became a comedian with music. You know, I was a comedian without music first,
mm-hmm.
but I was also a thwarted musician. So I just fused those together, you know, like the creature at the end of the fly. And that's how I became the act I am now. The best stand-ups, I think, the best gigs, and you see other people doing this, they wonder where you come away and think, wow, that night I did something I always do, something I haven't done for years, something I made up last week, and something I made up on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
And all four of those things are hitting really hard. And they're equally good, you know? So you shouldn't give... It's no good doing only old jokes.
Mm-hmm.
It's no good doing only stuff you wrote last week. And it's not as clever as people think to make it all up off the cuff. Because there's a real skill to doing the stuff you do every day. The real skill is, yeah, putting it all together.
Mm-hmm.
My act is always big scale. You know, it suits... I am a band. And bands are better... in a big room in front of hundreds of people than they are above a pub in front of 20 people. That's that even before the music, that's what I'm like. You know, I've got a big face, I've got a kind of delivery, and just, you know, those venues in Edinburgh that are porter cabins, they can be so fantastic for stand-up, but not for me.
No.
I do those and I can just feel the audience going, oh.
Because it's too intense.
It's too much.
In that sort of box. Yeah.
And I hate that if I feel like people are wincing. It's like, no, this is the good stuff, you know. Don't flinch.
Mm-hmm.
But on the other hand, you know, I can't quite stop myself from going, bang, bang, because that's what I'm like. I'm like, if you're at the library and you open a book and then you find out then that it's large print for the partially sighted. I like to be doing what I'm doing. You know, when I'm running, I'm running. When I'm writing, I'm writing. When I'm reading, I'm reading.
Yeah.
When I'm eating, I'm eating. Drinking, I'm drinking, etc. You know, it seems like a simple principle, but it isn't. I think you should, you know, if you're doing something in life, you should do it properly or not do it.